जय श्री गुरुदेव।
हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट वन ऑफ द ब्यूटिफुल एंड फेमस पोयम बाय W.O.B. ईट्स, दैट इज व्हेन यू आर ओल्ड। व्हेन यू आर ओल्ड, व्हाट डज द टाइटल इज सजेस्ट मीन्स, इट्स द टाइटल व्हिच इज द हैविंग द थीम ऑफ लव। सो वी ऑल नो अबाउट लव विल चेंज अकॉर्डिंग टू द सीजन। Do you think the love will change according to the season? If the love changes if someone gets older, in this poem, though William Butler Yeats, the W.O.B. Yeats is telling, going to tell, is the love changes is one get the, if somebody get the old, it become age. That's what he is supposed to say here. W.O.B. Yeats, the full name of him is William Butler Yeats. He is an Irish poet. And his period is from 1865 to 1939. What was his period? He's from 1865 to 1939. Was an Irish poet. Where his period is on 20th century. He used to write, his writings is on 20th century. And he awarded a Nobel. He was prized by the Nobel Award in the year 1923. In the year 1923, he awarded Nobel Prize. W.O.B. Yeats is the famous writing in the English literature who used to write more on love poems. The love poems will be written by W.O.B. Yeats. And in this poem too, When You Are Old is the poem on the theme of love. He has the one of the girlfriend, her name is Maud Gonne, who is a girlfriend of W.O.B. Yeats, who is an Irish nationalist and as well as the actress. Both Maud Gonne and W.O.B. Yeats, the both are very good to each other, the both are very familiar to each other, they know each other very well and they converse each other very well. But the Maud Gonne, who was a very bold lady and very brave lady, was very familiar, who was very close to W.O.B. Yeats. But what was the feeling that the W.O.B. Yeats had for Maud Gonne, but the Maud Gonne had a feeling for W.O.B. Yeats, means Maud Gonne, who was a brave lady who will criticize his poets, means he was an admirer of his work. Means Maud Gonne, who was a lady who was the great admirer of the W.O.B. Yeats. Admirer means who admires someone's works or someone's whatever they will do. W.O.B. Yeats is the famous poet and the novelist which means Maud Gonne, who criticized. Even he made a critical appreciation, he made critical analysis on the works made by the W.O.B. Yeats. So in the year 1891, what W.O.B. Yeats has done means he proposed Maud Gonne. Maud Gonne, who is a friend of W.O.B. Yeats, but W.O.B. Yeats having the different feeling on Maud Gonne, whereas Maud Gonne having another feeling towards W.O.B. Yeats. So he proposed in the year 1891 to the Maud Gonne, but the answer will be rejection. What? She rejected W.O.B. Yeats because she never had such feelings for him, so she rejected. And again in the after 2-3 years he again proposed her, but again that's only happened. It's happened around 2-3 times. He was proposing her, but the rejection will be happening. That's what happened. So, in that mood of rejection, this poem has written in the mood of rejection. In the mood of rejection, he has written this poem. What does the poem contains means? The poem starts in When You Are Old. As the poem, its title itself, the poem as well as it starts as When You Are Old, grey and full of asleep. Grey means what? As aged. The grey means grey hair. All you are familiar with the grey hair means the hair of the color color of the hair which be turns to white or gray color, so which indicates the symbol of old or aged. So the age of the when you are old, when you are means what here, this is addressee. Addressee means what? Addressee means if something addresses, andre if this poem is addressing to the Morgan, here Morgan is called as the addressee for whom the poem is addressing. So addressee, to whom the poem is addressing, that the person is called as the addressee. So addressee is the Morgan here. So when you are old, you here is addressee, that is Morgan. Morgan, when she became old, full of sleep, means the people who are aged means they were started to sleep where they are. They were very in the mood of tiredness. So without doing anything, they feel tired. So that's what he is saying. When you are full of sleep and you are old and gray, nodding by the fire. We hope you all familiar with the most of the English films that you seeing the people sitting in front of fire and reading the books. That's the habit of the people in an eastern countries. So take this book. Book means take this book. Nodding by the fire means while you are sitting in front of the fire in your on your easy chair while you are reading, habit of reading books, because as we all know about that she was the lady who reads books, especially the W.B. Yeats, who is a great admirer of his work. So while you are reading my books, book means take this book, which is the book of poems which has written by me. Me here is the W.B. Yeats. So while you are reading this, take down this book, means while you are sitting in front of fire, read slowly what I have written, means you are rejected me right now. What the Morgan has did to him, she rejected W.B. Yeats. So this poem is on your read slowly. Just read out the poem very slowly. Dream of your soft look. When he is saying her to read, when she was old, when she is old, he is saying her to read the poem. But when what it recall her to means dream of soft look, means that is the she is when she is reading this poem, she is old right now. So just go through your soft look, means it's recalling her your youthness. Your youth will be recalling now. And eyes had once, your eyes were very tender. Tender means very soft, very warmth in the nature, so very pleasantful your eyes were. So it's recalling your youthness when I proposed you. You were when I proposed you, you were very young. But when you are reading this, means you are just recall the youthful of your things. Then when eyes are once, moment of glad grace. Grace means the youthness which were very happy. When the people or a girl who is very young, that she was very enthusiastic, very warmth, very gladness about her beauty. So just these are all recalling your old days. And beauty, that is true or false. What he is supposed to say means you are young. At that moment you are young. The many people who had followed you, who had admired you, who had fall for you, but it may be a true love or it may be a false love. That he is supposed to say means the beauty which you had for once, which you had before, means most of the people including me which had a love for you, but those people who had loved you, those are all just an infatuation or love for your beauty. That's it. No one has loved you as me. That's why in the next line he's saying means there is a one man who loved your pilgrim soul. What does he mean by pilgrim soul? Which is the divine soul in you. One man. Who is that one man? The one man is the me. Me means W.B. Yeats is the one who loved you. That's in the soul within you, soul in you, which is very pilgrim. Pilgrim means divine soul you, which is the holy soul you. Means, as we all know, she was admiring his works. which is who is supposed to say boldly about her word, love that he had for her means the many have to, as we all know that many people who had loved you but not your soul, because he knows her very well, because the only girl who used to say directly about his works, whether it is right or wrong, she says directly to his face. Thus, the bold character which impressed W.O.B. Yeats, that's why he proposed her, because the only one who understands him, that's the notion of the W.O.B. Yeats, that she will understand me because I'm a poet, which he used to write everything, and she was admiring the works of him. So that's why, so that I loved the soul within you, which you come to me and say my work about, say your opinion, say you are criticizing my works. That's what he said. Many people who loved false love, but the one man means me, the W.O.B. Yeats, who loved the pilgrim soul, the divine soul in you, and the sorrows of changing face means you are an actress, you are an Indian Irish nationalist who used to met with many circumstances in your life. So you have met with many circumstances which changes your faces. It may be led you to sorrow. Thus, you even not only you, he loved your beauty, your pilgrim soul, but in your sorrow look also he loved you. Who? W.O.B. Yeats had loved you. There's a changing sorrow face. That's the sorrow face which was loved by me, means W.O.B. Yeats, that he's supposed to say. And what he say means bending down glowing bars. So that he is suggesting means bending down. So what the book will, this poem is, it all recall you, means the past of your youthness, the past of your life which had means, and bending down means when she was reading this poem, when she is reading this poem means she is old, means bending down. Bending means she can't stand or sit straight right now, which means bending down, she has to bend, as we all read in the An Old Woman in the last year, which means how would the old woman look like? She was very bent herself, very ugly to look. So that's what he is supposed to say here, bending down, which means in the glowing bars. Glowing bars means where she was sitting while reading the poem, means in front of the fire, which means glowing means which is the bars, means that the light had come from that fire, which means she used to sit in a bent form and read that poem. And murmur means saying the words in a very quiet way, means in a silent way, which feels sad for the love fled, means just you recall that, you recall that what I did was, means I proposed you but you rejected me. So you will murmur, you can't say it in the loud in a higher way, that love which you rejected me, but what you have to do now means you have to murmur. You have the right to say in the slow voice, low voice. So you feel sad for it, because the love which I loved you in you, which means the pilgrim soul, but which was rejected by you, but while you are reading, when you were bored, you will feel sad for that. For what purpose? For rejected my your love. And in the last two lines means which the love, my love is not only a love which means paced upon the mountain overhead. That love is which you are expecting right now, which you are feeling sad for, that means it is not alive right now, which is gone away. To where it has gone to means it has paced upon the mountain overhead. Mountain means it just climbed the mountain. Mountain means climb the mountain means which is mountain which is very high. Mountain which means very very high mountain, that which is go and sit in that, they were in on the mountain. That by this he is comparing that the love of which he had for Morgan is like the height of the mountain. So that he, that the love is go to the mountain and paced it and there sit and hid his face amid of the crowd of the stars. by climbing the mountain and it joined his face. Here the love is personified. His means is any male candidate here prescribed to? No, his it is love, which we it, love andre anyway, which love is a neutral gender. It is neither a particular to female or a male. It is a neutral gender, which means his face means love's face means love, which is personified here. Personification means what? Personification is a figure of speech which a non-living thing is used to be say as it has a life. So love, which is go into the and hit his face. His face means the love's face and in the middle of the stars. That's what he is supposed to say here. Means he making the personification by saying, by highlighting his love means that which the love he had for Morgan, which is very in the higher way. That's the love, the peak of the love of the WB is a like a mountain which is never alive right now, because where the love right now which you are expecting right now, that is in the midst of the stars. Means that is that the purity of my love he is supposed to say. And here the time frame had prescribed here, which means future, present, past and again the future. The time frame will be particularly over here, which is totally, which is very beautifully organized by the made by the WBE right? Future. Firstly, he talks about the future, which means when you are old. When you are means when you are old, which means in the future. While you are reading means here, when you are old, the poem starts in the future when you are gray and sleep, and the present. Present tense means what you are doing right now. You are reading the book of mine. And past tense, after read you this, what the memories will recall means the past of your life. That's what. And the future. Future means it will be immortal. My love will be immortal. So future, present, past, future, that's all the things will be included, where the poem starts with the future tense and ends in as well as in the future tense. That's what he is supposed to say here. The total theme of this poem, which means the WBE who proposed Morgan, but he got a rejection once, not twice, it means a thrice or four times. But that's what he is supposed to say. When you are old, you are habit of reading a poem of mine, which means you will regret or you will repent for what the love you rejected by rejected, what the love you rejected, what the love which I had for you rejected, that you will repent when you are reading this poem. That's what the WBE had said here. Thank you.